Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy D-Lloyd. So we're here, 2-6 is our record, looking to get our third win in a row. But very quickly, before we hop into the actual gameplay, let's take a look at the top 10. Oregon is number 1, Virginia Tech is number 2 still. Then when you look at the BCS rankings, those two are actually flipped. Virginia Tech is number 1 and Oregon is number 2. But as long as those two stay undefeated, those two are slated to play against each other in the national championship game. But for our game, we are actually back on television, you guys. We haven't played on TV in a long while, but we're here taking on Ole Miss. They are currently 5-3. Like I said earlier, we are 2-6. So hopefully we can somehow try to win our third straight game. We started 0-6. We came on strong, winning the last two in a row. Like I said, we're going to try to win our third straight matchup. But we have a very, very tough matchup here, and hopefully we can win on the road. When you ask Lee Corso who he wants to win, he's going to pick Ole Miss, obviously. But we're coming for the huge upset. So let's go ahead and jump straight into the comments there. You see right away, they're going to hand it off to the running back, Rogers. He gets a gain of about 8 on that one. Right here, the handoff to the fullback. He gets the first down. So now first and 10 for Ole Miss. You see Norman taking the drop back right there. He's going to find his fullback again, who makes that reception. Then right here they go with the play fake, looking for the fullback who makes a reception. And then he gets a gain of about 7 yards. So the fullback very involved early in this offense. But right here we come up with a huge sack. And now it's going to be 3rd and 9 for the Ole Miss Rebels. You see Norman throwing the interception right there to Wallace, who comes up with that pick. We're going to take over after stopping them. And now hopefully we can go down the field and get some type of points to start off this ball game. So first down, we go with the receiver, jet sweep, but we lose 2 yards on that one. Then the very next play, trying to take a shot down the field, Bruce Hickson is going to underthrow it because he doesn't have enough throwing power. So now it is 3rd down, taking another shot down the field, and this time it's going to be inaccurate. We try to throw that corner route. He threw this one to the inside shoulder for whatever reason, and that was right into the hand of the Ole Miss defender. So now they take over, but look at this, the very next play, we come up with that interception right there. So now we have the football in Ole Miss territory at the 37-yard line. So we go with a play fake, Hickson taking a shot down the field again, but this one is going to sail on him as it goes out of bounds. 2nd and 10 now, going with a play fake, Hickson looking to his left, but he ends up being brought down for a sack. So now it is 3rd and 20. Bruce Hickson sees the pressure, trying to take a shot down the field, and this one's going to be dropped by Jackson. We will have to punt the football as he couldn't hold on to it. A huge drop right there. That would have been absolutely clutch if he would have held on to it. But regardless of what happened, Ole Miss now has the football, and they're going to try to drive down the field. Handing off to the running back right here. He's going to be able to power his way for a couple of yards. 3rd and 3 now, going with a play fake. Norman with this nice touch on that pass. That one will be completed to the receiver down the middle of the field. Now under center, Norman trying to check down to the running back, but he throws it behind him. So that one is technically ruled as a fumble. So now they get the football on 3rd down. Norman stepping up into the pocket, and this one was almost intercepted as Peoples drops that pass. So now we have the football, but right here it is 3rd and 8. Trying to get the first down, have an open receiver, but we're going to overthrow him. But luckily for us, that's going to be a neutral zone infraction. So we get another opportunity, 3rd and 3. We go with the jet sweep, but we end up losing all those yards right back. So we have to punt the football back to the Ole Miss Rebels. They got 3 minutes to go here in the half. You see Norman going with a play fake, taking a shot down the field, but this one is intercepted, and we are getting the football right back. So now from the 45-yard line, 1st and 10 in the shotgun formation, we're going to complete this one the horn, and we are now back in Ole Miss territory, trying to get some type of points here before halftime. Trying to check down to our running back, we're going to overthrow him there. 3rd and 15 now, we need to come up with a huge play to keep this drive alive, have an open receiver, but we're going to end up dropping this pass, and that will end up taking us to halftime. So an uneventful first half, 0-0 is the score. Now the first play of the third quarter, we're going to go ahead and hand it off to Austin, but look at this, he is met in the backfield by the linebacker, loses 2 yards on that carry. Right here, Hickson's going to find Jackson, who has room to run, and Jackson will end up picking up a first down before being pushed out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Now Hickson dropping back, once again overthrowing a receiver. 3rd and 9 now, dropping back, trying to get something going, and this time we're going to actually complete the pass as Anderson gets his foot down and bounds. The next play we go with the jet sweep again, that's going to be Horn, but he's going to get tackled on one-on-one opportunity. So now we have to get something going. This is Hickson dropping back, but instead This one's going to be intercepted. I was hoping we could lob it over that linebacker. Did not do it at all. So now Ole Miss has the football. Now they're going to try to drive down the field and get their first points of the ball game. By the way, the fullback getting involved with that reception. Right here, the handoff to the halfback. That is Rodgers breaking through some tackles. And Rodgers is going to take this one into Alabama State territory. Second and 10. Hand it off to Rodgers again, finding another hole to squeeze through. That will be a gain of about 14 yards. Here they go right back to the ground. This time only getting a gain of about 4. Third down now for Ole Miss, going with a play fake, but they're going to find the receiver able to hold on to the football. So now it's going to be first and goal from the 4-yard line. Hand off to Rodgers. He's breaking out of a tackle, and Rodgers is walking into the end zone for the game's first touchdown. So the score is 7-0. We got 30 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Going with the play fake, actually going to complete this one to Anderson on that dig route. Now the next play, we're going right back to Anderson on that same dig route. Another reception right there. But then the last play of the third quarter, looking for a slant route, we throw another interception. So now Ole Miss has all the momentum, you guys. They're going to try to go down the field and get some type of points here. And look at this. They pull out the trick play and out of the Wildcat formation, throwing a touchdown. We were run committing all the way. Thought there was no way they were going to throw the football, and they definitely caught us off guard. So they went from a 7-point deficit. Now we're trailing by 14 points. We need to get something on offense. We need to get something quickly right here. Football once again going to sail on us. Third down now, rolling out of the pocket again, which is typically a huge no-no. And it's going to be a huge no-no again because that one's going to fall incomplete. So now Ole Miss has the football. First and 20, they fumble it. But look at this. Even when they fumble the football, they're able to get some type of yardage. Right here, Norman dropping back. He's going to complete this one to Kennedy, who makes that reception. And Ole Miss is looking to try to go up by 21 points. But then the very next play, going with a play fake, lobbing this one up. And luckily for us, this one will fall incomplete. Second and 10 now for Ole Miss, trying to throw this one to the flats. But instead, that's going to be Peoples, who comes up with the interception. He is actually going to outrun the quarterback, and Peoples is gone. A pick six, a huge pick six, because just like that, this is now just a one possession ball game. 4 minutes to go in the game. You know they're going to try to run out of the clock. So the first play handed off to the running back. He's going to get a gain of 3. Third and 7 now. They're going with a play fake this time, and this one will be completed for a first down. So the time is not on our side whatsoever. Ole Miss is going right back to the ground, handing off to Rodgers, making some nice moves. And he will make this a 3rd and 6. So we think they're going to run again. They go with 2 play fakes, and they end up throwing this one in the flat for a first down. That is absolutely huge. Now we're running out of timeouts, but we have to come up with stops consecutively on this possession. No more first downs, but instead of a first down, Rodgers will take this one to the end zone for a touchdown. We went for the strip there. That was our last ditch effort. Didn't that pay off? And the Ole Miss Rebels are going to win. They're going to advance to 6-3 on the season. We are going to fall to 2-7. So even if we win out, we are no longer bowl eligible for this season, you guys. So final score, 21-7. Looking at the stats once again, pretty awful looking at them. Bruce Hickson was 8-for-28, 0 touchdowns, 5 total interceptions, you guys. Hasn't really been a good year at all. Hopefully some of our recruits, if we get any, could come in and do something to try to change the ship around. I told you guys from the beginning, this is definitely going to be a project. It's not going to be a quick fix. We're not going to be balling in year one or year two. But if you guys are enjoying this one, definitely leave this video a like. Subscribe if you haven't already. It's your boy D. Lloyd. I'm going to see y'all next time.